Hi everyone, this is Lee, welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time here, you want to see videos about game development and programming, consider subscribing and turn on the bell, then you won't miss my next episode. In this video, I wanted to give you some updates about the turn-based strategy game I'm working on, Dungeon Slayer. I've been working very hard to improve the game based on the feedback. Thanks to everyone who leaves the feedback and comment, you guys are awesome. The first one I would like to cover is about the movement range display. Initially, that's what it looks like. For some game, it is okay, but for Dungeon Slayer, I would like to build out some convincing scenes, which means I will add a lot of details to the terrain and the environment. The highlighted hexagon kind of messing the ground too much. Even I have used some transparent effects already. The first solution I can come out is that I can use some simple hexagon for the display, just like this one. But the problem is that it looks too simple. Then I consider adding some gradient color effect to the shape. I used my limited graphic design skills to make an image with a gradient effect. Now I think it looks better than before. To make it look better, I even added some animation when the mouse moves around. Everything should work fine now until I saw this. I'm still not happy with the result. Because the unit only moves a couple steps, it is okay. But I would like to give the hero more movement points, which means the player can control the hero to move long distance to explore the environment. Then I decide to go to the boundary line design, like XCOM. While the process is not that attractive, most of the time I have no idea what I'm doing because I always got some weird result. But things start getting better. Now this is how it looks like. I think it looks much cleaner now. It took me some time to get the result, as I didn't plan this on the front, which means I have to dive into the framework and make some changes to cater for this new feature. But I think it's still worth it, because the player can have a better experience, especially the movement is quite common when we play this game. I'm happy with the result. To publish the game on Steam, we need to have a trailer. Even the game is still under development, but I think it is okay to make a gameplay trailer. In this case, more people can know what the game looks like. Also, I would like to get some feedback about the game trailer as well. I haven't made any trailer before, so I learned some skills from some other game developers. I would like to make the length of the trailer within 1 minute. I built a couple levels of the game and recorded the gameplay for 2 or 3 times. We need to be patient here to get some interesting footages. Then I used the video editing tool to add an effect and transition. I also made some changes on the trailer based on the feedback from the community. Now that's how it looks like. Another one I would like to change is the movement style. Initially, the character moved as a zigzag, just like this one. I tried to solve the problem before, but the result is not that good. I decided to give it a try again, because I really want to see the character move smoothly and naturally. Still, I have to make some changes in the framework to cater for this new movement style. Now that's how it looks like. I think it looks better. When I fixed the movement style, I found some performance issues. The FPS drops quite a bit, something wrong with the changes I have made. Luckily, we can use the tool provided by Unity to figure out what the problem is. The tool is the profiler. If you haven't used this tool before, you can find some tutorials from YouTube. It is quite simple. Just go to the Windows, Analysis, Profiler, choose the Hierarchy option, play the game. Then you can see the statistic graphics. When you see the peak, you can simply click it, the game will be paused at the same time. Then you can see what script caused the performance issue. Because I have too much fun when to fix the performance issue, I will skip this process here. After fix, the FPS increased from 30 to 50. There's always room to improve performance, but I will leave it for now. Do you like the changes I have made above? Please leave a comment and let me know. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe and give me a like. Your support is very important for me to keep making the game and videos. Thanks for watching. This is Lee. I will see you next time.